Hey kids, today we are making pizza tot casserole. We're going to start with 1.5 pounds of hamburger, a small onion and a small green pepper, or medium, chopped up. And we're going to go ahead, I want to cook this all together until the hamburger is no longer pink, and it would truly help if I turn the burner on, which I thought I put on a few minutes ago, so I could get some sizzle when I added it in, but of course not. We'll be right. You're supposed to add 1/2 pound of fresh mushrooms. I don't have any, unfortunately, so I have to use the canned stuff. You gotta do what you gotta do, people. Okay, so I'm finally getting that sizzle that I want. So this shouldn't take very long at all. Meanwhile, I've heated my oven to 400 degrees. And I know everybody on the mainland, you're all thinking, oh my gosh, it's too hot to put on the oven. And all that fun stuff. But we have heat pretty much every day of the year. So if we didn't cook in the oven or on the stove when it was hot, we'd never cook. So we're pretty much used to it. You just sweat a ton of water out, you know, you just sweat and then you rehydrate and you deal. All right, almost. Okay, so I have drained the fat. We're gonna add in about a teaspoon of dried basil and a jar of pizza sauce. It's not quite a jar. It's left over from the pizza we made. And I think it'll be okay because it will be. I'm just saying. All right, we're going to mix it up. I have a casserole dish that I have sprayed the Pam spray up in it, and you might call it non-stick spray. We're gonna toss this into it. I don't think it really needed it, to tell you the truth. The spray, you know, the oiling or whatever, the greasing of the pan, because the hamburger and stuff is enough. But now we're going to add, because it's a casserole, we're going to add all kinds of cheese to it. It's 3 cups of shredded part-skim mozzarella. So I'm going to just decorate the top of this with it. And when Scott came home and he saw the recipe book that I was using, he said, ooh, are we having, what is it, Italian spaghetti and meatballs? Which is on the opposite page. And I said, no, I'm making pizza tot casserole because it's weird. You know, to top a casserole, a pizza casserole with tater tots, to me that's just weird. And I like to do the weird, but I like to do the weird that I know we're going to eat. So, having put the cheese on the top of that, we're going to now cover it with a 32-ounce package of frozen tater tots. However, I only have about a third of the package. So, it's not going to be totally covered like it should. It should be absolutely covered, but don't hold it against me. Alright. There you go, people. My oven just booped. Perfect timing. I'm going to bake this uncovered for 30 to 35 minutes. We'll be back. Bye, pizza tot casserole. See you in 30 to 35 minutes. Okay, so there you go. That's the end product for me. However, the recipe goes on and says to sprinkle 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese on and throw it back in for another 5 minutes. But I'm not going to do that because there's already way too much cheese in here for me. And I know you cheese heads are going to do it, so go ahead and do it. This is it. Pizza tot casserole. Enjoy. This is very, very good. I'm not a fan of mushrooms, and so the mushrooms, you know, are like, are they really necessary? But, you know, everything always lends a flavor to every recipe, so definitely leave them in for at least that. And there's a lot of cheese, so I'm really glad I didn't add that cheddar on the top. This is really good. I hope you give it a try. Why do I always continue to act like I'm Tammy? Anyway, let me know if you do. Bye.